There isn't anything more satisfying than slaughtering countless masses using ranged weapons. Am I right, or am I right? Hello, lords and ladies. I hope you're all doing well. Today we're going to have a look at the best ranged units in the game. Primarily, I'll be judging them on their ranged prowess. This will include their raw damage output per shot, rate of fire, accuracy, and how these figures are affected by their skill ratings. Secondarily, we'll have a look at their melee prowess and armor ratings. Just to clarify, this is for footmen only and will not include mounted archers, and I'll only talk about units that are tier 5 and up. This will, however, include regular units, elite units, minor faction units, and mercenaries. So without further ado, let me introduce you to our contenders. When it comes to shortbows, we have the Azrael Master Archer, Kuzeit Marksman, Imperial Palatine Guard, and Sturgeon Veteran Bowman. For longbowmen, we have Battalion Fian, Battalion Fian Champion, Brotherhood of the Woods Arboreal, Wolfskin's Chosen Wolf, and Forest People Forester Veteran. Lastly, for crossbowmen, there are Imperial Sergeant Crossbowman, Vlandin Sharpshooter, Company of the Golden Boar Boar Champion, and Mercenary Hired Crossbow. Before I begin, I'll show you a small infographic which presents how their skill ratings affect their capabilities on the battlefield. Also, when talking about ranged unit specific stats such as the damage, you need to understand that the way I'll calculate the damage for these units is simply the damage of the bow plus the multiplied value of their skill, which only applies for bows, plus the damage of the arrow, which also only applies for bows. Keep in mind that this is the raw damage before you take the shot, meaning that the projectile speed multiplier and enemy armor value aren't taken into consideration, as they will vary. Also, all damage done by ranged units is pierce damage, which gets a 1.7 times damage multiplier if it hits a head, and this isn't taken into consideration either, as you never know what your units will hit. I also wanted to speak about the range of these units, but the difference is minuscule between bowmen with something funny like 2-3 meters, and crossbowmen seem to outrange them all together by about 6-8 meters. With different terrain on every map and not being able to create a test room for these things until the devs released their tools for modding where I could create an environment specific for these type of tests. And the last point I want to bring up is the fire rate I will present you with, which is the maximum fire rate mathematically speaking. In game you'll probably see units fire slower as they take time to aim, obstacles such as trees might get in their way, and so on. Now that you understand this, let's have an in-depth look at these units. Starting off with shortbowmen, the Azrael Master Archer comes with an above average skill rating due to his 160 bow skill earning him the elite status. Armored pretty well with 30s across the board and a solid armor rating of 2.3, making him a heavy boy indeed. Lack of shield definitely puts him on the back foot in the melee, however the step recurve bow with 46 piercing arrows to unleash upon his foes allows him to make sure they don't get there. He can deal 76.91 damage per shot with a fire rate of 27 shots per minute and 100% accuracy. Kuzeit Marksman comes with slightly poorer skill rating, standing at 4.33 average. However, he makes up for it with his improved armor compared to the Azrael Master Archer. In the melee, he might take an extra hit thanks to his 2.63 armor rating. Coming armed with 48 step arrows and same bow as the previous guy allows him to correct his mistakes. He deals 72.87 damage per shot with a fire rate of 27 shots per minute and 100% accuracy. Palatine Guard also comes around with a 4.33 average skill rating, however he has the armor of a behemoth standing at 3.21. Where he loses out though is his equipment. Armed with a poorer bow and only one pack of arrows puts his potential damage below a half of the previous two. However, he can manage melee pretty well with even numbers due to his armor. He deals 67.01 damage per shot with a fire rate of 26 per minute and 100% accuracy. Sturgeon Veteran Bowman still comes around with a 4.33 average skill rating as his bow is slightly higher at 140, sacrificing 10 points in one handed. He wears the poorest armor out of the four and will definitely not have a good time in melee combat. Even though he comes with the same poor bow that the Palatine Guard uses, he actually gets 2 packs of arrows, allowing him to dish out more damage than the Palatine Guard, but still less than the Azrael and Kuzeit archers can. Per shot, he dishes out 65.62 damage at a rate of 26 per minute with 100% accuracy. Moving on to Longbowmen, the Battalion Fian's skillset is mirroring that of the Asurai Master Archer, being an elite unit, the difference being that the Fian prefers to fight with a two-handed falchion in the melee, greatly increasing his melee capabilities, which is aided by the fact that his armor rating stands at 2.17, making him a heavily armored unit indeed. He comes with a deadly woodland longbow and 64 boltkin arrows. He deals 87.67 damage per shot at a rate of 28 shots per minute and 100% accuracy. Battalion Fian Champion is the only tier 6 unit in this contest, and his skill rating well reflects that. But I'm afraid the devs forgot about his change to a one-handed weapon, which results in poorer melee prowess compared to the regular Fian. We also see a minuscule decrease in AOR and his ranged equipment remaining the same. However, his ridiculous bow skill allows him to dish out 95.59 damage per shot at a rate of 28 shots per minute at 100% accuracy. Even though he's only a tier 5, the Arboreal rocks a better skill rating than most. However, his piss poor armor definitely puts him on the back foot, leaving him with low durability. His bow is no woodland longbow, but with 40 arrows under his hand he can dish out a fair amount of damage, standing at 75.43 per shot at 28 shots per minute with 100% accuracy. Chosen Wolf is slightly less skilled than the Arboreal and comes with even poorer armor. However, he does come with a nice oval shield to offset it, and gives him a better chance in the melee, although a hit or two will take him out of the fight. Naturally, coming with a shield means we can only get one set of arrows, and oddly we have two loadouts coming with two different longbows. With the woodland longbow they can dish out 87.26 damage per shot, but if they end up with a woodland U-bow, they'll only deal 72.88 damage per shot. Both can fire at 28 shots per minute with a pinpoint accuracy of 100. Veteran Forester, just like the other minor factions bowmen, comes with a great skill rating but poor armor. Not as poor as the previous two, but still pretty poor. Coming with a deadly woodland longbow and 40 barbed arrows allows him to pack quite the punch. He deals 88.84 damage per shot at 28 shots per minute and 100% accuracy. Imperial Surge and Crossbowmen are a pretty decent unit. With an average skill rating of 4.33, like his shortbow friend, he has behemoth armor, standing at 2.82. Unlike majority of archers, he comes with a weakish shield, making him a decent infantry unit when out of ammo. With his hickory crossbow and 20 bolts, he can inflict some pretty good damage with 93 per shot at a sluggish rate of 13 per minute and 100% accuracy. Vlandian sharpshooters are as skilled as the Imperial Surgeons, coming with a decent armor rating just below 2 on average, however they still make it into the heavy category for me. They're backed up with nice Bavai's shields with 530 HP, making them beasts at melee. Armed with a bound crossbow and 20 bolts, they can unleash 100 damage per shot at a rate of 14 shots per minute at 100% accuracy. Boar Champion is better skilled than the Vlandian Sharpshooter, earning him the elite status, however he comes with poorer medium armor. He does get to wield the Pavai's shield too, increasing his melee capabilities drastically. With a fine crossbow and 20 bolts, he deals 95 damage per shot with a rate of 14 shots per minute at 100% accuracy. Coming around to the last contestant of today, we have the Hired Blade, a mercenary crossbowman with a pretty low skill rating for a tier 5 unit. However, his high crossbow skill makes him elite. His armor isn't anything special, but he does come with a fortified guide shield, which is the Imperial equivalent of the Pavai's. Like the Vlandian Sharpshooter, he's armed with a bound crossbow, allowing him to dish out 100 damage per shot, at a rate of 14 per minute, with 100% accuracy. This about wraps up the unit's in-depth stat. Let's talk about the top 5. Joined first comes the Fians, simply because they're technically the same unit, and with the largest arrow pool and great damage output, they also have the greatest damage potential out of everyone here. Coming second is the Veteran Forester. Yes, he mightn't be the most durable, but he can dish out plenty of damage and has reasonable amount of arrows to back it up. Coming third, we have the Asurai Master Archer. Being able to deal a decent amount of damage per shot with 46 arrows under his belt, the heavy armor he comes with also leaves him with high durability. It's the Kuzite Marksman who takes my 4th place, as his 2nd largest arrow pool, coming with a 2.63 armor rating and decent damage, rightfully earns him this spot. And coming 5th is the Vlandian Sharpshooter, able to dish out 100 damage per shot at a slow rate, but having heavy armor and a Pavai's shield, makes him great at holding walls during sieges or for melee engagements during prolonged combat. But that is just my take on the best ranged units in the game. Is this the top 5 you expected, or did you hope to see another unit in this top 5? Let me know in the comments down below what your top 5 is. Like always, if you liked the video, give it a like. If you didn't, give it a dislike. I'd also appreciate greatly if you subscribe. While here, I would like to say something about the Minor Faction Contest. So far there have been only 2 entries, so if it's something you'd like to take part in and give it a go, go ahead into this short video. I've had problems with my email the last few days, so if you're creating a folder with your faction, I'd like to ask you to change it to a Google Doc and leave it in the contest video comment section instead. Having said all that, have a good day and the best of luck on the fields of Calradia.